take that qaida. If these people they say what they upon is the truth, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would have do it, commend it to the Sahaba, and himself he'll be the first one to implement it. Because as the hadith said, that there is no prophet that ever came except that he will clarify the good and the truth that he know for his people. So therefore, that he mentioned here, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, giving us the understanding of this verse. Shaykh Fawzan hafidhahullah say, Az-ziyada, here another liwajihillah. Az-ziyada, it is to be seen or looking at the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we also, as a point of aqidah, we take it and we believe that Allah has a face. We take it as our religion. We believe also that Allah has a face. That Allah has a face. Not like how these people, barakallahu fikum, of the aqlaniyun, they do. If something does not fit their intellect, they will kick it to the curb. Or they will take another sifat and replace the other sifat. And in matters of the sifat, you cannot take one sifat to explain another sifat. You cannot take one sifat to explain another sifat. For instance, you cannot take the sifat of al-qudra to explain the sifat of al-yad. Fahimtum? You cannot take the sifat of qudra to explain the sifat of al-yad. But rather, you got to establish and affirm both of them. Bima yaliqu, in that which is befitting for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as ziyada here, another liwajihillah. He say here, hafidhahullah, shafadhan, he say here, the ziyada, it mean looking at the face of Allah. May Allah make us among those who will see his face, yawm al-qiyamati, ameen. But he say, what is the sabab? What is the reason why these people will have, they will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala face? As-sabab, annahum ahsanu fi dunya. And the whole reason being that they exercise what is called al-ihsan in this life. What was that ihsan? Ya'budun Allah, they worship Allah, ka'annahum yarawna Allah, as if they were seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, فَأَعْتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى. Allah Jalla Ala gave them al-husna, وَهِيَ al-jannah, which is al-jannah, the paradise. وَزَادَهُمْ, and he increased them, رُؤْيَةِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ, he increased them in what? In seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shaykh Salih al-Fawdan, he went to say, he said, تَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ, that you worship Allah, كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ عَلَى الْمَشَاهِدَةِ. He said that you worship Allah as you are witnessing him, as you are seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, number one. Wa mahabbata, and as also in regard to loving Allah, and longering ila liqa'ihi, and longering for meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning having this strong desire to be meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, tataladha. He say, and likewise, you are feeling delighted bita'atihi, in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are delightful. You feel very much delighted in the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, the person is not being burdened. He's not being burdened by the worship of Allah. As you have some individuals, for them it's a burden to fast the whole month of Ramadan. For them, it's a burden to pray. For them, it's a burden to be giving the zakat. For them, it's a burden to be, barakallahu fikum, doing the act of obedience to Allah subhanahu. It's a burden. But amma the muhsin, amma the person that have ihsan, he is being delightful to be doing what? To be doing the acts of obedience to Allah. وَتَطْمَئِنَّ إِلَىٰ تَاعَتِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَلَىٰ. And he is finding calm and tranquility in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he is even being eager, having eagerness to be meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and having eagerness in regard to the acts of obedience to Allah. The Shaykh Hafidhahullah, he say that indeed this is the way, that this is the path of the people that exercise ihsan. So this was the first martaba of al-ihsan. Al-martabatu al-thaniya, the second level of ihsan, is that إذا لم تبلغ هذه المرتبة العظيمة فإنك تعبده على طريقة المراقبة. That if you did not reach that level where you are worshipping Allah as you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the second level is there for you. That you are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala على طريقة المراقبة. Meaning that you are worshipping Allah in the way of that you are watchful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have watchfulness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He say, bi an ta'lam anna Allah yaraka. That you know, it is that you know that Allah jalla wa ala indeed without a doubt he's seeing you. Wa ya'lam, and the person he knows, meaning and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows haluka, your position and your situation and your condition. Wa ya'lam, and also that you know that Allah also he knows ma fi nafsika, that you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know what is in your inner self. Right? That you also know that Allah knows what is in your inner self. As Isa alayhi salatu wasalam said, ta'lamu ايش ما في نفسي ولا اعلم ما في نفسك. That you indeed, O Allah, know what is in my inner self, and I do not know about your inner self. So he mentioned, hafidhahullah Shaykh Salih al-Fawzan, he say that also the person know that Allah jalla wa ala know ma fi nafsik, that Allah knows in regard to that which is your inner self. So therefore, فَلَا يَلِيقُ بِكَ, it is not befitting for you, أَن تَعْصِيهِ, that you are disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَن تُخَالِفْ, and you are in opposition of his command. You are in opposition of the amr of Allah. وَهُوَ يَرَاكَ, and he is seeing you. And not only he is seeing you, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is observing you in a way that nothing is, barakallahu fikum, skipping his attention and his seeing and his hearing. Nothing. And he mentioned, hafidhahullah, wa hadhihi halatun jayyida. This is a good situation. This is a good way, meaning worshipping Allah upon being watchful of Allah. This is a good one. Right? It's a good one, barakallahu fikum. Because if a person is worshipping Allah in a state of watchfulness, he know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompass him. He know that Allah encompass him. Right? He know that Allah encompass him. Right? Innahu la tudriku al-absar wa huwa yudriku. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no eyesight can encompass him. But Allah Jalla wa'ala encompass everything else. That Allah encompass everything else. So he said here, yes, it is a hal, it is a level, it is a situation that is good, that is favorable, that is good. Walakinnaha aqal, but also it is lighter or it is smaller in virtue than the first one. It is smaller in virtue, in superiority, than the first one, even though it is good. He say, وَمَا دُمْتَ أَنَّكَ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ يَرَاكَ فَإِنَّكَ تُحْسِنْ عِبَادَتَهُ. He say, as long as you know that Allah sees you, then you are going to bring about perfection in your worship. And you are going to do it with perfection and completion. Why? Because you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sees you. He say, لِأَنَّكَ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَرَاكَ, because you know for a fact that Allah Jalla wa'ala, he sees you. He say, وَلِلَّهِ المثل الأعلى. He say unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or to Allah belong the best and the highest examples. And why the Shaykh Hafidhullah mentioned this word, وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى, because he want to give us an example. He want to give us an example. He say, for instance, لَوْ كُنْتَ أَمَامَ مَخْلُوقٍ, if you were in front of a creation, he's just like you, a person, he's like you. But lahu manzila, but he has a high hierarchy. He is your supervisor or your boss. He is somebody that has some type of superiority, right? On in regard to the status, let's say whether it is in the job, in school, whatever the case might be. But he has a manzila fawqaka. He has a level that is a little bit higher than yours. Wa amaraka bi amrin, and he commands you of a command. Right? So let's say we have a job, and let's say the boss is right there, the manager. He says, hey man, just move this from here and put it to place such and such. And he is right in front of you. Right in front of you. And he say that you will be doing that action. You will be fulfilling and executing that action. Amamahu, in front of him. وَيَنْظُرُ إِلَيْكَ, while he is looking at you. Now I think this is enough for us to understand how every one of us will do what? Will do that job. I don't care how sloppy you are at work. Right? But if the job boss is the boss man is there, you know the boss man is there. Sometimes you can tell. I mean, you come, let's say you come second shift. Right? But you come, you find everything is like on point. Everybody got their uniform tucked in. Everybody's doing something. Now you will know, man, something must be up in here. Somebody from the big shots must be here. Come to find out, the CEO is here. Do you think anybody would play around? No, you won't. So therefore he say that you are doing that, you are executing this action. Amamahu, in front of him. وَيَنْظُرُ إِلَيْكَ, and he is looking at you, he is supervising you, he is watching over you. He say, هَلْ يَلِيقُ بِكَ أَنْ يَقَعَ مِنْكَ إِخْلَال. He say, will it be fitting for you to commit an error? Would it be fitting for you to commit an error? Would it be fitting for you to be negligent بِهَذِهِ الْفِعْلِ, on that action? Would you be negligent in that action? Would you carry out that action with negligence? Or you will carry big, like, man, you the man of the job. You will fulfill that action like never done before. You will take your time, make sure that all the requirement possible, you will do it. If you're working at a construction site, right, the boss man is there. The first thing you will take is what? Your hard hat. That's what you're going to first put, because they sent you gone. It's a pink slip for that right away. Right? So therefore, he mentioned, Hafidhahullah. Then the question that she asked us, then do you think, هَلْ يَلِيقْ بِكَ, is it befitting for you, أَنْ يَقَعَ مِنْكَ إِخْلَالٍ, will it be fitting for you to be negligent about that action, or to be committing these mistakes? He say, you will, of course, the answer, we will all say no. Nobody will be lackadaisical or negligent in front of their manager or in front of their boss man. Al-Hasil, and we suffice ourselves with this conclusion. In summary, the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, he say, أَنَّ الْإِحْسَانَ عَلَى مَرْتَبَتَيْنِ. In summary, know that Ihsan is of two levels. He say, the first level is the martaba, that is the level of witnessing with the heart. Witnessing meaning seeing it with the heart. In other words, seeing Allah with your heart. He say, وَهِيَ أَن تَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ, it is that you worship Allah كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ. He say that you are worshipping Allah as you seen him. مِن شِدَّةِ الْيَقِينِ وَالْإِيمَانِ, from the strength of iman and that which is al-yaqeen, certainty. He say, كَأَنَّكَ تَرَى اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ, as you are seeing Allah with your own eyes. This was the first martaba. The martaba to thaniya, The second level of al-ihsan, وهي أقل